Hi, nice to meet you. Thank you for coming in. You're my 3 o'clock appointment, is that right? Great. So we're here today for a bit of a clean-up of your general skin, isn't that right? Yeah, and you said over the phone that you've got some blackheads that you'd like to be removed. Yeah, of course we can do that. I'm also going to do a little bit of a microdermabrasion, removing some of the dead skin cells on your face, giving you overall a little bit of a fresher look. Does that sound okay? Yeah, of course. So we're going to be removing most of the dirt and the excess sebum from inside of your pores. Brilliant. Okay, so before we begin, I'm going to pop my gloves on first, of course. At all times, I'd like to keep myself as sanitary as possible so that I don't pass any dirt over into your pores. The microdermabrasion exfoliator will open the surface of your pores slightly, meaning that they are more susceptible to getting dirt in and then creating the excess oils, and then that's where we get the spots and the blackheads. Okay, so after this session, I would suggest that you don't wear any makeup or any harsh product on your face for at least 48 hours. Okay, great. Okay, so before we have a look at your skin, I'm just going to give it a bit of a quick cleanse. Now, I did ask you to come in without makeup on today, and I see that you've done that. Great, thank you. I just want to take one of my cleansing wipes and just give it another quick cleanse, just to make sure that there's not any excess product that could potentially get into the deep pore. Okay, great. So we just use the Simple brand here. These are the Spotless Skin Quick Fix wipes. We'll only need one. There we go. Okay. So this should just feel really refreshing on the skin. Just going to be rubbing the oils from your skin. It does seem like you've got a little bit of makeup left. So we didn't quite get everything, but that's okay. Okay. And on the nose. Of the nose. Okay, and if you could close your eyes for me, I'm just going to gently, very gently wipe underneath the eyes, on the other eye, and then keeping your eyes closed. Going to wipe on top of your eye and the other eye. Okay, great. finish up on the chin. Great. Okay. So, now that we've got a little bit more of a clean surface, I'm going to quickly inspect your skin and then we'll take our microdermabrasion exfoliator. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to come a little bit closer now and I'm just going to have a little look at the quality of your skin now. If you could just close your eyes or you can just stare behind me. Whatever you'd prefer. So what I see some blackheads around the nose area, down the bridge of the nose, and then just around the sides and then the very corners. We also have some whiteheads on your chin. Now we don't seem to actually have any what we would call spots. I'm only seeing blackheads and whiteheads. However, you do actually have a few what we call melia under the eyes here. Now, melia are very, very, very small little white bumps that can form under the eyes and around the nose area. Now, these are nothing to worry about, they're not harmful, and they won't actually grow very big, they stay quite small. What they are is basically a build-up of sebum, which is the oil that our skin produces. Now, it is similar to blackheads, but there isn't actually a surface pore for the sebum to rise to the top of the skin. So that's why we end up with these little bumps. Okay. So I do have a way of extracting these if you'd like me to. Yeah, it won't be painful. Great. Okay. So, now that we've had a little bit of an inspection, is there anything that I should know before I start our little procedure? Have you got any extremely sensitive areas of skin, or do you have any history in your family of like skin diseases or rashes that tend to flare up? No? Any allergies at all? Not that you know of. Okay. Well, that's great. Okay. So, I'm going to take this microdermabrasion exfoliator, which we use the number 7 brand. Now, this is suitable for sensitive skin, so you should be okay, we shouldn't have any issues. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a small amount of the exfoliant and we're going to be rubbing it in circular motions onto the skin, starting at the chin and going in circular motions upwards, and then starting at the centre of the forehead and going round to the temples, and then we're going to take a small amount and we're going to sweep it on the nose very gently. The thing with microdermabrasion is we want to avoid sensitive areas. So, for example, the very corner of your nose or under the eyes and the lips as well. Anywhere that can easily break the skin or that has a lot of blood vessels. Okay, so we're going to take a little bit here too much. I'll pop that down for now. Okay, I'm going to just rub it into my fingers a little. Okay, now I'm going to start at the chin. And then slowly moving our way up the cheeks, and it shouldn't feel too harsh, it should feel a little bit rough, but not too much. Great, and then on the forehead. Working our way down to the temples. Okay, and finally we're going to take the excess that I have. We're just going to sweep it along the bridge of your nose. Okay, brilliant. So now that we've done that, the important thing with microdermabrasion is that we don't rub the skin for too long. It's recommended no more than a minute, and it's ideal around 30 seconds, really. Okay, and now I'm just going to take another cloth, and we're going to gently remove the exfoliant. Skin. Just get the nose and the chin. Okay, that's great. We'll pop that down for later use. Okay, so now that we are finished with exfoliating the skin, the pores are now open and visible enough for me to start the extraction. Okay, so I have my little tools here. Okay, just open them up, and you'll see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different extraction tools. Now we shouldn't be using this one here today. This is like a little hook, and this is used for bigger kind of cysts that need to get out, or larger blackheads that have gone quite hard at over time. What we will today be using for the blackhead removal is I have this tool here. We will be using the rounded head here. Okay, and what this does is you can put pressure. So imagine I've got a black head on the back of my hand. You would put pressure around the black head, and we use a very, very gentle twisting motion that isn't too painful on the skin, and it will just gently remove the black head out of the pore. It's common that people tend to pop spots and blackheads on their own with their hands or their fingers. Now this can be quite dangerous, especially with somebody with poorer hygiene, especially with long nails, because we can keep quite a little bit of dirt and bacteria underneath the nails, and then when we break the skin, that bacteria can get in and then create more of a problem. It can cause infections, so we do suggest that you do come to one of our extraction clinics like you've done today, because all of our tools are sterilised before use, so there's no chance of any infections at all. And these are actually less harmful than squeezing, because when you squeeze, you're gonna slice the skin, whereas these are just gentle and we tease the blackheads out. Great. So are we all comfortable and ready to begin? Good. Okay. So I'm gonna be starting on your nose. So if you want to close your eyes, that's perfectly fine, whatever most comfortable for you. I'm going to be taking the tool and I'm going to be very gently twisting like so. And what happens is we'll collect a few different blackheads. They're coming out quite easily. Once I've collected a few, I'm going to take my wipe and I'm just going to remove the sebum onto the cleansing wipe. Okay, so just stay still for me. That's great. These are quite recent blackheads. You don't have very many older ones, so do you try and remove them yourself? Yeah. Of course, it can be quite expensive to sometimes come to a clinic to get it professionally done, but I would suggest that you just for the sake of keeping your skin nice and cleansed. Okay. Good. We'll carry on. This time we'll get into the corners of your nose. I'm just gonna push up. We'll try some of the whiteheads on the chin. Okay. We've got a tougher one here. Okay. So there does seem to be one that doesn't want to move. What I'm going to do is I've got another tool that I can use for cases like this. So we're going to take this tool. Now, it seems as though that this whitehead is not actually a whitehead, it's a blackhead. Now, you know it's a blackhead because, of course, the pore appears black in colour. Basically, what happens is and the sebum becomes oxidized, so it turns harder. So you'll see when you squeeze a blackhead, it's black at the surface, but then as you continue through the pore, it gets clearer. So that is actually what the sebum and dirt actually looks like. Okay, so because it's quite an old kind of blackhead, I have this tool here, which is more rounded in shape. So what this allows me to do is I can apply pressure to the entire surface around the blackhead, meaning that I don't have to tug so much, and it's going to be less of a sweep like so, and more of a pressure. So this may hurt a little bit more, so please do let me know if it is hurting you too much. Okay, so we'll come in now. I'm just going to apply pressure, and again. All sorted. Great. Now I'm going to take my original tool. We've just got a few more to extract. Okay, got about three or four more. So I will be sterilising these again before we use them on another patient. Now, in regards to the melia under your skin, I do have a specific tool which I will show you now. So this tool, again, has a similar hook to the other extraction tools that we were using. However, this time, I don't want you to panic, we have this little sharp edge. Now this is very, very sharp, it's like a pinprick. So what will happen is I'm going to pierce the very, very surface of the melia, which will allow me to extract it. As I said before, this melia are under the surface of the skin. They don't have a pore to escape through, so by me poking the surface of the skin, I'm creating a pore to extract. Okay. Alright, so you may want to close your eyes for this as I'm coming towards your face with a sharp object. I don't want you to jump in anyway. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pierce them all first. Okay, and then we'll extract them. Great. So if you want to close your eyes for me, I will just poke, 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 poke. On the other side. There we go. Wasn't too bad, was it? Yeah. If they were larger in any sort of way, I would have injected you with some nerve numbing agent, but I don't feel like it was necessary. They're very, very on the surface. Okay, so we'll take the hook, and I'm just going to coming away quite easily now. not. Okay. So we are all cleared up. Just going to pop my tools away properly and I will clean them. Okay, so before I let you go, I'm going to again take a clean cleansing wipe this time and just re-cleanse the surface of the skin. Of course, there are some pores that are quite open as I have pushed dirt out of them, so we're just going to make sure that all the oils are removed from the surface of your skin so that you regain those filled up pores. I would suggest that you try your best not to touch your face. I see a lot of people messing about with their hair and they'll sit with their hands on their face or touch their face quite a lot, and it can really create a lot of dirt. We carry a lot of bacteria on our hands, and putting that in pores is never a good thing. Good. Okay. So we'll just take a wipe again. And it's a brand new clean one. Okay. Now I'll just wipe the skin. Looks like we're all good there. Is there anything else that you'd like me to have a look at today? You think you're good? Okay. Right, so that was quite a quick session. But if you have any worries at all, you can phone the clinic anytime and ask any questions you may have. You're more than welcome to come back at any time for an extra blackhead extraction, or if you have any worries about any areas of skin at all, we can have a look at those. Okay. As I said, try not to touch your face if you can help it, and just take good care of your skin. Make sure to cleanse and moisturise morning and night. And if you are going to bed, please, please, please don't go bed with any makeup left on your face, okay? And if you can, try and avoid wearing makeup or any really, really strong moisturisers for 48 hours. Okay. Great. Well, thank you for coming in today, and I will see you when I see you.